Yeah, so Jeff, obviously you're a fan of the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
It's what taught me to be a fan. Yeah. It was the first thing I had thoughts. I remember like knowing how to think, and then I remember loving the Ninja Turtles. Just married together.
Same. So the movie it's incredible. We love this movie so much. We've both seen it twice already. Like, just absolutely amazing.
Oh, thank you.
What was the unique vision you had? It's so specific and it's so beautiful looking and hilarious.
It really started with focusing on the teenage part, which in early conversations with Seth always felt like the most underserved of the four descriptors, and we wanted to cast actual teenagers and create something that felt authentic, and then we decided to reflect that in the art. We looked at the way we used to draw when we were in high school, when you're like so passionate and you just don't know how to draw, but you don't know that you don't know how to draw yet. So you'll like lovingly like draw a hand and like every fingernail and like every wrinkle on the knuckle, but like the hand is like horribly misshapen and doesn't. There's no formal art training to encumber your pure expression. And they were like, let's do that. Let's make the movie look like that. Yeah.
Was there a piece of concept art or a drawing or something that you said, this will work? This
can. Yeah, I think some of these early ones, like the characters, like there's an early drawing of Bebop and Rocksteady that I'm just like, oh, this is, I have not seen characters in animated films look like this before, and if we could pull this off, like, it would be really, really exciting.
And then you tried for several years to pull
it off. And then we tried and failed for many, many years. But I guess the other thing is when I think back, so much of my love of Ninja Turtles, like, I love the live action movies, I love the show, but like the toys is like really how I connected with it, and I spent a lot of time with those toys. They're so inventive. There were such wonderful designs with so much work put into them, and they were weird, and they were gross sometimes, and we're like, we should let this movie be as gross and as weird as that whole bevy of stuff in the early 90s that kind of shaped my taste and childhood.
You succeeded.
Yeah. And you talked about the teenage aspect. Do you want to talk about, because they actually recorded together.
Yeah.
Which is not... It's not usual.
It's awful. It's horrible. It's a horrible thing. It's really bad for sound because everybody just talks over each other. But we got all four kids together and we went in with a script and we had this idea of like, okay, this is the joke that the teens will say and they'll sound like teenagers, and it felt alien and weird because Seth and I are not teenagers. So we immediately like threw the script out and would just have them improv everything and be like, how do you say that? How would you say that? How would you express this to your brother? Talk about a YouTube video that you saw. And they would say tons of things, and then we'd have to like fact check them and make sure it wasn't like super offensive or some like code that we didn't understand yet. But like so much of the banter between the turtles just came from recording them ensemble, and then also letting the tape roll in between takes, and just hearing them talk about their day, and then editing it into the film. Oh my God, the score! I love the score in this film. They were I don't know why they said yes to doing this. I still don't believe it, but they were so wonderful and collaborative and. They were like, we think the score should sound like a garage rock band or something, and you really hear it in the chop shop. But they really, really embraced the film, and it's really beautiful at points and emotional, and also really exhilarating. It was very exciting to work with them.
You said that their music made the movie better.
Right.
Yes.
Yes. You were worried about how good the movie would be when you were showing it to Trent Reznor and Atticus Ross, right?
Wait. What was the question?
You said you told us.
Because Seth and I were talking. We're like, oh, who should we get to compose this? You know who we really love and would never do it is Trent Reznor and Atticus Ross. They're like the best. And then somehow we got a meeting with them, and the meeting went well, and they're like, send us a script, show us the film, and we're like, one second, like, hold on, we have to completely redo a bunch of things to make sure this is, like, worthy of putting in front of you. But it made the movie better.
And you made an amazing movie that we've seen now, we can say that we've seen this movie, and it's amazing, but, yeah. What else, Charles?
Well, we're not done. Nowhere near it. Okay. We have a surprise guest, an icon, joining us on the stage.
That's right. Hall H, please welcome the co-creator of Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, Kevin Eastman.
The king returns.
That was awesome! Right? Isn't that cool? Man.
Kevin, you've been
so excited. I'm so proud of what you guys have done. This movie just is brilliant on every level.
That is so. Really makes me legitimately emotional.
Well, honestly, I'm watching it, again, and I'm taking in every moment. I've seen some footage, and you first showed me footage, and I was like, 15 minutes, and I go, when are you starting the sequel? But no, I look at it, and it's just the way it's come to life, and reminds me a lot of, the underground comic style that Peter and I started with the project, and it just so much life and energy and weight, and it's beautiful. So, you guys dig it?
Yeah. Well, Kevin, you've been to Hall H many, many times before.
Yes.
But what is it like being here with this iteration?
This is my 38th year at Comic-Con. I love coming here. Peter and I first came here in 1985, and it was a much different show. I think that year they were hoping for 7,000 attendees. And they'd be at 7,000 people in this room for pizza. No, it never gets old. The fans, it's a chance for me to say thank you for giving me such a great life, such a great job. And almost 40 years later, I'm still drawing turtles.
Yeah.
Doing this kind of stuff. Thanks to you guys. So thank you.
He will not draw a turtle for each and every one of you, so just get that out of your mind. But you do have a kind of a special announcement today.
This is really exciting.
Yeah.
Actually, this is really exciting. You guys are gonna love this. As we just found out today, you guys, this is breaking news, seriously, that Nickelodeon and Paramount have secured the rights to broadcast next year the original cartoon series.